In the dark, the crippling blackout continues there, a desperate situation growing worse. Tonight, our team inside a hospital where the power is out, and families now across Venezuela say their loved ones are paying with their lives. Tonight, the U.S. now responding to claims from the Venezuelan president that the U.S. could be behind the blackout. ABC's Tom Llamas is in Venezuela again tonight.
Tonight, Venezuela's most needy, trying to stay alive in hospitals just like this one, with little or no power.
So you can see this is the situation here in some hospitals in Caracas. There is no power. This is a private hospital. They do have a generator, but it's not enough power to power the entire floor at times. You can see patients are being wheeled out in the dark. This is the reality in Venezuela.
Guiding us through this dark maze, the hospital's ER chief. The facility invited us in to see the desperation. Parts of the hospital relying on a generator, but they have to conserve power to keep patients like Romero Andrade alive. Since the nationwide blackout 6 days ago, he's been in a coma, battling colon cancer. His daughter tells me they were treating him using flashlights. The director of the hospital telling me they are running out of time. Already, they've sent some patients home.
I have 67 years. Never in my life I have seen something like this.
All of this as reports of stores being looted while families scavenge for food and water anywhere they can. The crisis on full display right through the center of Caracas. Families getting water from this polluted river. President Maduro is blaming the United States, without proof, accusing U.S. hackers of sabotaging their electrical grid, crippling the nation, and leading to chaos.
And so let's bring in Tom Llamas reporting from Venezuela tonight. And Tom, first off, what's the reaction from the Trump administration tonight about these claims from President Maduro that the U.S. could be behind the blackout? And secondly, are U.S. diplomats leaving as they've been told to do?
Well, David, first, Secretary of State Mike Pompeo says the U.S. played no role in the collapse of Venezuela's electrical grid. He says the real culprit is Maduro's, quote, incompetence. Now, the U.S. is taking no chances here in Venezuela. They are pulling out all U.S. personnel. And Secretary Pompeo says it's because of the deteriorating situation here in Venezuela. And, David, we have seen it everywhere since we've been here, from people taking baths in that river of filth to mothers carrying large jugs of brown water to the darkened hospitals, even the airport still has no power, David.
All right, Tom Llamas, great to have you back in Venezuela to put a spotlight on this desperate situation.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.